Hello and welcome to Code to Start with me, Mohammed Fathi. We are still talking about C#.NET Core. Today I am going to talk about C# data types. C# is a strongly typed language. It means we must declare the type of a variable before we can use. So first I am going to create a new project called data types. Open start and type cmd to open the command prompt and type dot net new console. First I'm gonna go to our C# projects on the C#, English. So I am here in the folder called English inside C# folder inside the C. So I am gonna create a new C# project called data types. So .NET new console. Can example rename it variables or demo2. Can name it data. Data types and press the we should put dash in the name of the project is called data types and press enter. The project will be created. I am gonna go inside this folder cd data and press enter. I am gonna open this project with the VS Code or Visual Studio Code by typing code dot press enter. The project will be created in our Visual C# or VS Code. Gonna open the program .cs. This is the project. First I'm gonna declare a variable. To declare a variable for example int age equal 22, this I'm gonna declare a variable. I'm gonna declare a new location in our memory called age. So in the last lecture we divided the memory into two parts, stack and heap. This will gonna create a new location. The location will be in the stack called age and assign a value 22. C# can't declare a variable without type. This is wrong. If I remove the type, this is will make the compiler unhappy and complain. Because each variable in C# must have a data type, any data type. What is the data type? We are gonna divide the data types into two main categories. C# data types, we're gonna divide into value types and reference type. All the value types will be on the stack, and all the reference types will be on the heap. Reference types will be on the heap and the value types will be on the stack. The value types are gonna divided into value types like symbol types, integral data types like numbers, whole numbers, floating points, decimal numbers like decimal numbers, char and boolean. And examples of value types like enum types is a value types. Struct types is a value types. Nullable types is a value types. Reference types can be, for example, any class, any user defined class or any existing class or predefined class. Interface is a reference type. Array is a reference type and delegates is a reference type. We'll declare all of these will be clear in upcoming lectures. Data types, for example, value types like byte, s byte, short byte. It's 8 bit unsigned integer from 0 to 255. S byte, it's signed byte. It can contain negative numbers. For example, you can see this by example. You can, if we gonna declare a variable, a byte b equal 255. This will be okay, and I can print this by console dot write line b. Can open the terminal and type dot net run. The project will be compiled and running, and the output will be 255. This is okay. If I can, I can store 256. This will be complete because the byte contains numbers. Byte contain numbers from 0 to 255. I can make a variable called if I 255. If I make a variable of type s byte, the compiler will be complete because this contains a negative numbers. Can contains from negative 128 to 127. This is okay. If you increase it to 128, the compiler will compile in, but can contain negative numbers from this, from 128 to 127. There is another type called int. Int if int i1, for example, equal this is complete. Why? Can see write the text representation specify 32 signed the integer value by the current line. Okay. This is because if you make this long, and this will not complain because this number was greater than the int type. If you can see the int type, 32-bit signed integer, this is the range of values it can contains. You can see we can divide the data types into integral bytes like this. This is integral bytes. We can go to this is integral bytes for long u long. This is integral byte. This can hold whole numbers, and this can hold decimal numbers. Float double decimal. There is another type called char, and this is store character like this. If you gonna go to char C1 equal between single quote, you can store a char. For example, any character, for example, A or B or C, any character can be stored in this. If you wanna to print it, C1. And run called b the output will be like this. Bool and object. Bool store a boolean data type. For example, true or false. Object any types is the parent type or the base type of all other types. All data types in C# inherit from the object type. A string is a sequence of characters like this. If you can store string my name equal Muhammad, can console to write dot write line my name. This is string sequence of characters. I can't store sequence of characters between single quote. It's wrong. Only between single quote is the char. A string must be between double quotes. So let's go to this. The string, what happens with this line of code? This is called the reference data types. That will happen. The compiler gonna create a new location in the stack called my name. And gonna create an object on the heap and store the value Muhammad here. And any object or any location on the heap must have a reference or must have an address like 0x01. This object contains the value Muhammad, and this variable will contain this address 0x01. So this is called a reference type, and this is called a value types. This contains actual value, but this contains a reference to another memory location. This is very, very important because the data types is value types like this and reference type like this. Any of these types contains a location on the heap and a reference on the stack. Location on the heap and the reference on the stack. Please don't forget to share and subscribe to our YouTube channel, and thank you.